What else?
Do the acoustic version. You gotta sing it.
You gotta laugh. Ooh, oh. Every style, every shoe, every color. When you're famous, it could be kind of fun.
Did it stop? It sounded like it stopped. Well, I know my camera be sounding like that when it stopped, but I don't know.
Maybe this.
When it makes that noise? Or is that not the camera? That could have been your AC.
Oh, this is still going.
Oh. Yeah, my camera be sounding like that, and I'd be so sad. When I lose
footage, I ain't gonna lie. That happened on last episode that with Garrett.
You like, thought you was recording?
Yeah, like we was. So most of the episode got recorded. It was supposed to be like a 40-something minute episode, but it was like a 31-minute episode. Mm. But anywho, all right, in 3, 2, 1.
Do you have like an intro?
My name, yeah. But you know what I'm saying.
Make up a jingle right now. Wait, what's the name of it?
The Brothers Podcast is the best podcast. Yeah.
I think y'all should remix the Wayans Bros.
The Wayans Bros. Oh. How did her stuff? Oh yeah,
We're happy every color.
Give you a high five.
Y'all should do.
All right, cut that. Yeah, facts.
Or something, so you can't
what
get
would
copyrighted.
Be a fact? Facts. What would be a good remix off of that?
I don't know. I gave you the idea. You gotta
facts. Everything. I can lead you to water, but I can't make you drink.
Right.
But anywho, hello, party people. It's your boy. Camo McLovin, aka Black Chip Skylark, going crazy. That's enough. Y'all can, you know, come see me in concert. Yeah, name later on this year. Ticket starting at $50. Low seat $500 plus tax. Backstage passes, VIP access, all that other stuff.
That's crazy. Come get me. That's like considered a low price right now. Like
$500. Oh, everything. Low. Like
people charging bands to
facts.
Be on the floor.
Niggas not paying rent.
Yeah.
They like, nah, I can miss
taking
this much.
Man,
what?
Okay.
Yeah, Usher.
And it's always worth it. I know it is.
But is it though?
I know it is. To a Beyonce fan, seeing Beyonce
I say
front
for,
row, that I'm
true.
Sure that is worth your rent.
But it got to come with backstage pass. Like, Beyonce literally got to shake my hand, give me a hug, all that.
Beyonce
I'm talking
doesn't, I don't think she does meet and greet. She can't. I don't think, she's too famous. I don't think she can do that.
Yeah, but like, if I'm spending $2,000.
Yeah, you're going to get a black shirt. Beyonce, maybe a little lanyard. That's it. You're not going to talk to Beyonce.
Like, can you at least look at me? Can I get a wave in or something? Like,
that's crazy.
Like 2,000.
So if you really like get far with the music and the guitar, and they say you are gonna be as big as Beyonce, like you know for a fact,
mm-hmm.
would you be like, okay, yeah, let's do it?
Just to be as big as Beyonce, or like the
like
ticket?
If it was if God literally told you, you gonna be famous, but you gonna be as big as Beyonce,
yeah,
you'd be like, okay, yeah, let's do it.
More or less, it depends. Cause like, I don't really like to be in the spotlight, and I don't too much like people like that. So like, I would want the wealth of Beyonce, but like the fame and like everywhere I go and somebody taking a picture of me and want to be up in my face, like nah.
But you can't have one without the other. So would you do it or not?
I mean, there are some billionaires out there that we don't know about now. Just
I'm talking about Beyonce.
True.
Think about her life. Do you want it? Or are you going to be like, nah, I'm good? Are you signing the contract?
Are you?
You got 10 seconds to sign the contract. What are you going to do?
I'll sign the contract. I'll sign it. But that's because I'm going to do folks like how Marshawn Lynch did. I ain't talking to nobody. God dang, I'm shades on, you know what I'm saying? I'm here so I won't get fined. I'm going to do what I got to do.
Marshawn Lynch is not Beyonce.
But so you tell me I gotta act just like Beyonce, so like I gotta.
You don't have to act like her. I'm just saying your life is gonna look like hers. Like, you can't just go to Walmart. You can't just go to Mexico. Everybody's gonna know you everywhere you go, and it's gonna be chaotic everywhere you go.
That might not sound the deal then, because I'd rather have peace and like incognito in order to enjoy myself. Because like, if I'm like how you say it, like if I'm on vacation and then I'm over here trying to do some jet skis, or I'm in line or whatever, can you take a picture, can you, like, not a thing close, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? That joke crazy.
But I think that Beyonce has to go, because she definitely be going on vacation. I think she has to go to like remote islands or stuff, like stuff that's
she probably got
not
an island
map.
Yeah,
she probably do.
Like, I damn sure have one. Like, if I, yeah, that's what, now I might have to sign that contract now, you know what I'm saying? I just got there and get that and then buy me an island, you know?
Yeah.
Made that be like Neverland or whatever the hell Michael Jackson had thing.
I guess
or make
that
it
is,
to an island.
Yeah, that would be cool, but that's cool for somebody who, like you say, like, I hate people and you want to be by yourself. But I feel like the best part about vacations to me is when I meet other people from like other parts of the world.
True.
Like, it's a very wholesome experience.
But that'd be the natives though. And the natives don't really too much. Well, if you Beyonce big, somebody gonna know you. But like, say if you just like a normal B-list celebrity or whatever, like you can still go to an island, you know, go to a vacation. You may get noticed by like one or two people, but like the natives ain't gonna really know you too much. After they see somebody take a picture, you'll be like, "Oh, who is that guy?" That's kind of crazy.
That is.
We done got that. Went a whole little 5 minutes into the thing without even giving you a proper introduction. That's how you know it's gonna be a crazy one. It's gonna be Cat Williams, y'all. y'all hold on to that, man. But hello, once again, it's your boy Cam on McLevin. We have a very special guest today. We have the greatest in the land. I don't think she needs any introduction, but we're gonna let her give you an introduction. You know what I'm saying?
I don't have one. Shiny the Great. That's what my name is right now. It might change later.
Is that today? It might be different tomorrow. But you know what I'm saying? Thank you for coming along, you know. Germs. Oh, yeah, facts. God, cleanliness is next to godliness. Yeah. Big ass thing. She got dang big boy. But tell the people a little bit about yourself. Shiny the Great, you know
this
what I'm saying?
A job interview? Dang, I thought we was vibing. I don't know that. I feel like when people ask me that and say, "Tell me about yourself," it makes me want to tell them how much I hate when people ask me to tell them.
That's something about yourself.
So, I feel like that question is just very like, "Hi, how are you? Impress me." Like, immediately impress me. And it's like, I don't know. I'm just I feel like I got to dig for something valuable to say.
Yeah.
That I feel like will impress people. And I don't feel like it's necessary for me to do that.
Okay. Well, what do you do, Shani the Great?
I don't like that question either.
Okay. So, what question do you want to be asked to you? You know what I'm saying?
I don't like that question either. What do you mean, what do I do? Like, is that all that matters? Like,
nah, not at all.
Because I feel like when people ask that, it's mainly as your career is what they're asking.
Yeah.
And it's like, I don't know that, like, what I do is not who I am. It don't really got nothing. It don't define me. So
facts.
I don't like that. That's such a, like,
I ain't gonna lie. When people ask me, like, what do? Like, I initially tell them, like, my personal, like, career and, like, instead of where I work at, I'm like, yo, I'm an artist, you know what I'm saying? I do paintings, videos, anything visual, you know what I'm saying, whatever we'll do. I'm also an athlete. I'm also the best. Like, the list could go on. Like, I could go this whole episode talking about, you know, about me because I'm that fine. But I'm not arrogant. So, people call me arrogant, but I'm not arrogant. You know what I'm saying? So, okay. You know, yeah. So, like, I'm a spiritual person, you know. I don't give too much detail because, you know, you can't give the people all the information about yourself. But just give them the basics. Well, you ain't got to, but, you know, I'd be like, yeah, you know, my favorite color is orange. I like basketball.
I feel like that's just so... Like,
it's basic, but...
Random. But I feel like if I had to say what I do, I just live life to the fullest. That's what I do. I'm a professional liver. Hey, not even a professional. I'm figuring it out.
Yeah.
I'm not at all a professional. But I feel like that's my priority in life, is to just live it in a way that makes me happy.
And that's what people need to hear and see. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, people are followers nowadays. Ain't too many leaders. But if people see, or if people follow the right leadership, you know what I'm saying? Like, living your life to the fullest and, you know, being happy, you know, all that stuff. That's a good thing for people to see and hear. Instead of, you know, I don't care. I'm a name drop because, you know, it is what it is. But, like, these strippers and... Yeah, dang, rappers nowadays, you know, I'm not shunning y'all. Y'all make y'all money. You know, y'all hustle, do what y'all gotta do, but y'all not making a good
representation.
Y'all not making a good representation for younger folks, man.
I'm shunning them. And I'll tell you why. I'm shunning them because I've literally specifically heard, I ain't gonna name drop, because if I blow up, I don't want to name drop it. But I have heard some celebrities literally say, I don't even like the music that I make. I just make it for the money, or that's what the label tells me to make. Or
that sounds like Cardi B.
The audience. Oh, that's exactly what I was talking about.
Yeah.
But yeah, I've literally heard her say that. And she's not the only one, but I just feel like, I don't know, why would you just be a sellout like that? That's exactly why I would shun it, because I do think she's talented. Like, I really like Cardi music. She really impressed me when she came out. I really liked her first album too, but I just feel like, I don't know, it's hard for me to respect an artist that I just feel like, are you really an artist if you're not expressing yourself authentically? Like, it's not even your art that you're putting out.
I was gonna say, I still classify them as artists, but you're not yourself, you know what I'm saying? Like, you're the label artist, you're not like yourself as the artist. So, like, say for example, like me, if I was to be in that situation, I'm like, hey, I'm Cameron the artist, or whatever. But then if I would have sold out or whatever like that, oh, I'm Def Jam's artist Cameron, instead of like Cameron the artist, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but I just feel like for something to be art, it has to be authentic. So
true.
For it to be fake, that's just like, that's not art to me. That's a show. You're putting on a performance, but that's not
necessarily art. Performing arts?
I don't think so. I don't see it as art.
Yeah, I don't. Like, if it's, you're not yourself, it's, yeah.
And it can be great. It's just not
authentic. It's not you.
It's not art. I wouldn't call it art. I would call it something else.
You gotta make up a word for it. What word'd you go off on?
I don't know. What did you say earlier?
Copacetic. What's copacetic?
That would make it worse.
Yeah, true.
But yeah, I'm sure there's one that exists. I'll find it.
I say words. That's how words are created. Words are just created. So you create your word.
But I would just like to see what Cardi can do without nobody else's influence. Really, everybody.
Yeah, I say everybody.
I don't even want to point her out. But I feel like even people who are not celebrities or anything, like, they, it's a lot of people living life, like,
that y'all not
about other people's standards. Facts. Basically. So I just want to see what the world would look like if everybody was moving authentically.
Oh, everything. Like, everybody ain't got ops. Everybody ain't got baby daddy, baby mama issues. Everybody, you know what I'm saying? Like, be yourself. If you go follow, or, you know, be like somebody else, you know, spread love and positivity. You know, be something with your life. Make something good out of yourself. Like,
yeah.
That's not funny.
That's fact, though. I really, I was talking to Xavier not too long ago, and he was telling me that he thinks that following your heart is actually, like, the key to life here, like, on Earth. And I really think that's probably what it is, bro. I'm going to test the theory. Well, not offense to, I am testing the theory, but feel like it's a lot of people scared to do that.
They don't know how to listen to their heart or theyself, because they get in too many influences and stuff from other people and other sources. Like,
yeah,
like, yeah, I feel like I should do this, but I'm looking on Instagram or hearing from this person, they doing it this way, and it's working for them. Like, maybe it should work for me, but it ain't for everybody.
I think, though, it's hard to blame everybody because it's very, like, what's the word? There's an agenda. Like, there's a reason everybody is like that and, like, hesitant to really go for it and follow their heart. Because when you think about it, ever since we kids, like, as soon as we learn how to talk, they put us in school. Like, it's like, immediately, you can talk, and I don't want you to say something too good or too wise.
Exactly. So, not individuals.
Yeah, let me start programming you immediately. Like, you need to start learning order. Like,
yeah.
You gotta wake up at 6 o'clock. You gotta come here every day, even if you don't feel like it. You gotta do this homework, even though you don't care about it.
Exactly. Even though you ain't gonna use it.
Yeah. Like, they're programming you and conditioning you to, like, through repetition, to keep doing things that, to just do what you told. And, like, because how much freedom do you really have in school?
Like, none at all. Like, so, especially when they used to have to wear a uniform, they just be so crazy.
So it's like, once you become an adult, it's like, it's hard to just be like, oh, it's your fault. Why aren't you following your dreams? But it's like,
I've been told, like, that I gotta give me a good job to do this and then do that. And not,
whole life, you got a good point. One thing, like, it's so much unlearning that you have to do. Like, unlearning has been more important and, like, helpful to me than actual learning.
That's crazy you said that, because that's literally, like, how I've been feeling, like, these past 2 years. And I just seen a video on that. Like, somebody was telling me, like, pretty much, like you just said, we gotta pretty much break down the foundation of what we learned growing up or whatever like that, because a good bit of it is not really true on how we should live and, like, the information we was given. So, like, we got to break that down just to pretty much rebuild it on truth and facts and how we feel as adults and stuff like that, instead of, like how you said, being as a kid, being told from adults or whatever, like, yo, do this or whatever. It's just crazy.
It is, because, like, as kids, we have such big imaginations. Like, we feel like we can do anything. If I want to do a backflip, I'm going to just do it. Exactly. I ain't going to be thinking about no fear and then, like, oh, what if I break my neck? Like, I don't know nothing about that. Exactly. I just want to do a backflip, so I'm going to do it. And, like, kids are just very fearless. I feel like they're so, like, I don't know, just pure. Like,
they're very pure.
They're worth being, like, observed and studied, because I feel like they just, they more tapped in than we are, for sure.
Most
they're
definitely.
Less, like, tampered with.
Mm-hmm. They ain't diluted with the world problems and being the life, just living life, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So that they, like, you know about Earth, Wind, and Fire?
Like, you know, the band?
Yeah.
Yes.
They got a song called That's the Way of the World. And it was like, stay young at heart, you know what I'm saying? Because, like you just said, like, when you're a kid, you living with pureness and just, like, straight up creative and, like, intentions or whatever. So, like, if I'm living peacefully and with a pure heart or whatever, only positive energy is coming to me and stuff like that. But if I think negatively and, or like an adult, you know what I'm saying? Like, oh, yeah, this person is trying to do this, so I'm going to treat them that way or whatever, whatever. Like, that's not the way you should live.
Yeah. It's
more or less.
I think for me, my experience as an adult too, well, another thing that just bothers me is people being like, well, that's not realistic. You got to think logically. Like, Chantel, you're so delusional. You got to be realistic.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, I feel like adults like to use that to think that they're mature or whatever. Like, but I feel like being realistic is really an excuse to, like, justify putting limits on yourself, mm-hmm. for real. Like, you're not thinking big.
Exactly.
Like, I'm thinking big, but you think that that's the best you can do.
Exactly.
So you're like, oh, you gotta be realistic, and I think that's so lame.
But yeah, they used to swimming in puddles and ponds instead of the ocean. Mm-hmm. So they can't see the ocean. They're like, the ocean? Like, what?
They in the aquarium.
They're not the aquarium.
They're in jail, literally. Like, people don't realize, like, oh, people be like, oh, slavery was so long ago. Y'all are still enslaved.
Facts.
Like, mentally.
Oh, everything, like, it's modern day, so, like, y'all don't think just because niggas ain't getting in chains or got, still to jail.
Yeah,
they're chained. So, goddamn,
yeah.
Like, just because, like, niggas ain't on the streets getting like whipped or whatever, whatever. They think slavery's over with, like, nah.
Yeah.
That junk way deeper than just the outside, you know. So that junk crazy.
And people got the nerve to scream like, "I'm not my ancestor. You can't try me like this. If y'all try it today, like, wake up, look around."
Like, look here, Tyrone. Did you not got they seals around your community? And you know, that's
stuff. That's such a crazy thing to say about your ancestors, like. But
that's another thing. Facts. Nah, you can talk about it. Like, you think they actually just like, "Oh yeah, you go ahead and hit me, you go ahead and do that."
Right,
nah.
Like,
and they said the thing, like, so do I wanna live right now, or do I wanna just die?
And they was smart. Like, how you know your ancestors wasn't running with Harriet and, like, I don't know, really changing stuff.
Facts.
Or you just never know. They definitely had way more community back then than we do now.
They had more community in the I'm a little under the influence, people. Yeah, I gotta excuse my verbiage, but the operative word in community, that's the right word I'm using. Like, the main word I like to focus on in community is unity. There's no unity in our community, because, you know,
for real, there is some.
A little bit, but it's like, it's not unconditional, you know what I'm saying? It's like,
yeah.
All right, so what you gonna do for me if I do this or whatever, whatever? Like, instead of just doing out the pureness on, okay, I want to see you win because, you know, you're in my community. You're like, you're my brother, you're my sister. So, like,
yeah,
let me help you, because then, and ultimately, it'll help me. Like, it'll come back around if it's in the community, so.
For sure. But that's what I was telling you earlier. Like, our, not even just our generation, but just the times right now, everybody just feel hurt and, like, heartbroken, and, like, they can't trust each other.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just like, oh, I'm gonna just worry about myself, because when I worry about other people, I get my feelings hurt.
Touch.
So everybody just, I feel like they're growing, like, a fear of showing that unconditional love to people, because they feel like they get taken advantage of. So it's like,
but that's relationship wise though, like, business wise, or just like, well, that's a romance relationship wise, like, just like,
not necessarily.
Would you be?
I feel like your friends, your family, like, it's a lot of people who can disappoint you.
Yeah.
And treat you in ways that you don't feel like you deserve to be treated.
Yeah, true.
Like, love.
They be the main ones that do it for real.
Yeah. It hurt even more when
it's, yeah, that's like anything.
But yeah, love isn't just, like, limited to romance. I feel like that's, yeah, the problem too. They, like, when they think about love, they just think about romance. But love comes in, like, all, so many different forms.
Most definitely. I agree with that. But I was, like, talking about, like, with the unity wise and stuff like that, like.
So, like, what do you think it takes to get back to that?
First of all, let me look at the camera when I say this. I'm not gonna call y'all niggas, cause that's below us right now. This is a black man and black woman talking to the black community right now, and every other minority or minority melanated community out there. What we need to do is help each other by lending a hand to each other without having a knife or a gun, you know what I'm saying, attached to that hand. We gotta help each other by goddamn supporting each other and, like, keeping the wealth in our community. Like if we know a black vendor or a black business or whatever, like, yeah, they may be a little bit more taxed or whatever, whatever. But y'all can't complain about the price, because, you know, y'all get Balenciaga's, Gucci, all that other stuff. Y'all don't tell them niggas, "Hey, bro, you come down a little bit on the price, bro." Like, nah, you got to support them, because then once you put that dollar in your community, he'll help you out. You know what I'm saying? If you got something going on. And that's another thing. If you don't got gun, if you don't have nothing going on, get you a trade or get you a group of people, y'all come together, you know, start something for the community or whatever. Like, it's a lot of stuff out here we should do and need to do for each other to get back to where we used to be. That girl Lauryn Hill said that in her album, like, Lauryn Hill's fly. But yeah, what do you think we should do?
I think for one, we need to prioritize being in, well, finding our tribe, I guess I'll say. Because it's a lot of people that's good at this thing, and it's a lot of people that's good at that thing.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like now it's just so many people just doing random stuff. They're not really doing what they're called to do. and they're not really fulfilling like what their role is supposed to be in a community. Facts. So I feel like once people really like lean into what they're really supposed to be doing and figure out their where like what their role is in society in the best way, because people say, well, what I believe is when you follow your calling, like, it's not just the best thing for you to do, but it's the best thing for, like, the highest good of all people. Most so, like, it's not just going to serve you. It's going to serve everybody in the best way. So, I feel like once people start doing that, and it'll be easier to work together because everybody will be on, like, a higher vibration because they're doing what they love to do.
Facts.
And it's going to give them, like, the results that they want. But I guess, yeah, I guess people just need to find out who they are and start embracing it. And I feel like that'll help them figure out how to embrace each other better. And then it'll just flourish from there. Flourish?
Yeah, that's flourish.
I don't feel like it has to be that hard.
It's not.
I feel like it'll naturally happen if everybody just, you know.
It should and can be that easy and simple, but, you know, the human nature of today's society, like, people don't they want the easy way. They don't want to do the difficult thing, or they can't see the difficult thing, or they lost people. So you can't help lost people until they find themselves, but they can't find themselves because they lost. So like, we gotta get them to get found first, and then that's when we're going to put out the other stuff. It's going to be like a domino effect.
Yeah. I feel like we are getting closer to that, though. You don't think so?
More or less, like, yeah, I think we are getting a little bit closer. But the gatekeepers, they trying to force the other agenda, you know, that make us go back, you know what I'm saying? Because, like, with the social media and stuff like that, they dropping a lot of valuable information for us, like, as the black people and, like, people of color to know and to have access to, but it's giving, or how many people will actually watch that or listen to it, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because, like, niggas got dang, will listen to the new hottest hip-hop track quick, but if you drop a dang 1 minute information, you know, like, video, they could barely hold the attention for 20 seconds. So
yeah,
I guess we gotta make it more fun and more entertaining.
Feeling,
yeah,
more feeling.
Yeah, yeah.
And there's a lot of people doing that. I've been listening to like R&B gospel, and I love it. Like, it's literally girls who sound like Summer Walker.
Facts.
Singing about God. I love it. Like, and I was like, why aren't they playing this? This is what's supposed to be on the radio. Like, kids should not be able to hear Sexy Red talking about
everything.
All of that on the radio. Like, that's everything. little 5-year-old's favorite song. Like,
facts.
That's crazy.
And they came and tell me what the hell 3x3 is, but you got, they ain't seen the lyrics word for word. That's just crazy.
Yeah, but it's like, if it's music out here that exists like this, like, why isn't that on the radio? Like, that's what need to be pushed.
The gatekeepers, the agendas. They don't want the agenda to be pushed. You know what I'm saying? So.
But I was going to ask you, because I do feel like the collective, like, overall, it's a lot of people, like, really, I feel like, waking up a little bit more today. Mm-hmm. But you were saying that it's a lot of people lost and, like, they got to find themselves. But I feel like therapy is, like, after COVID, they've really been pushing therapy. Like, and I was like, this is a little suspicious. Like, but I do feel like it was a lot of people who really needed and, like, just really got open to therapy after COVID.
Mm.
But, and it seemed like it's really helping people. So I'm just like, well, you were saying a lot of people are lost, but I'm like, it seems like a lot of people are trying to find themselves, like, through therapy. But how do you feel about therapy being, like, more, like, normalized today?
I think everybody does need to go to therapy, for real, for real.
Do you have therapists?
I need one.
I need one.
I need about one or two of them, for real, for real. Just in case, goddamn, the one therapist trip, I'm like, nah. I'm going to go to my other therapist right quick, see what he say or what she say, right. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, because, like, you know, especially in the black community, and then especially as a black man, you know what I'm saying? Like, growing up, you know, we was taught to, you know, not be emotional, you know what I'm saying? Like, like, keep it in, you know what I'm saying? You always got to be tough, you know what I'm saying? Like, don't ever let nobody see you cry or hurt or whatever, whatever. But, like, shoot, I'm a kid. Like, I don't understand everything, you know what I'm saying? I still don't understand everything now, but, like, especially as a kid, like, I'm going to be crying a little bit more, or I'm going to be, you know, even more emotional, because, like, I don't know what to do. And then especially, like, since I ain't had no, like, no father figure in the household, so, like, I had to goddamn deal with my emotions, like, how I deal with them. And that's kind of why I'm kind of reserved now, but I'm being more open, you know what I'm saying, like, now, because I'm learning and, you know, removing those toxic masculinity traits from myself. But I would say that yeah, like, therapy is very, like, needed, because, like, you can't, it's always good to let your emotions out, especially if they're, like, negative or whatever. So, like, you gotta tell somebody, and then you don't want to tell nobody who you close to or who you know, because, like, then they go judge you, you know what I'm saying? Or you feel like they go judge you or whatever. Like, everybody's not always that judgmental, so you just gotta know who you talk to. But a therapist will have, like, an unbiased opinion, because they don't know you, they don't know who the hell you talking about, they not finna see you and spread your word or whatever, whatever. Or if they do spread your word, you ain't gonna know about it, because, like, I don't run to a therapist every day, you know what I'm saying, or my therapist every day. I don't have one yet, but, you know, I need to get one.
Okay.
Cause, like,
love the honesty.
Because, like, I be thinking sometimes, like, yo, like, why do I be thinking like this? Like, is this human, like, humane for me to think like this? Because, like, that's another story for that. I'll tell you off camera, you know what okay. I'm saying? Yeah. But, yeah, like, therapy, I think it's needed.
That's interesting. I tried a therapist I've tried it like a few times. I never felt like I needed one though.
I was just psycho? Like,
no, I was just like, it's free, I'm gonna try it. Like, whenever I see free therapy, I love everything free. So I'm like, ooh, that's,
you know, they're gonna say free? Oh yeah, I'm in.
And like everybody say, well, everybody should go to therapy. So I'm like, let's see what they have about. So I was excited. And I mean, it was cool. My first experience, it was cool. I'm trying to remember if I, like, got emotional or anything. I don't think I did, though. I really don't really remember. I know I was in college, though. It was my freshman year in college when I went to Georgia Southern. And I didn't really make no friends in college. So, I was really just by myself all the time. But it didn't feel that lonely. Like, I was cool.
Yeah.
But, yeah, if anything, that's probably what I went in there talking about, how I ain't got no friends. I'm like, I don't even know what I would have been complaining about.
Yeah,
and probably, like, the fact that I didn't want to be in school because I did not want to go to college.
That part, too. Like, I did. Like, honestly speaking, at the fifth grade, I was tired of school. LSU, I took away my recess. This young is pointless. Like,
it is pointless.
This young.
I can't tell you anything I learned in school.
Man, what on everything? Anything. Literally, like, after that semester, or that half of the year, I never use that information again.
Yeah.
Like, that's just crazy.
It's so crazy. But literally today, I'm doing my taxes confused. And I'm like, if every single person has to do taxes, why didn't they teach this? Like, exactly. Why am I confused?
Exactly.
Why don't nobody understand nothing? And they got to do with our money. Mm-hmm. Like,
they took away home ed.
I don't know.
But
crazy.
Anyways,
I got sidetracked.
Yeah.
I was talking about, I feel like, well, it was interesting to hear your perspective, because I be feeling like I don't need a therapist. Mm-hmm. Like, even after going to a therapist, I was like, I don't think this is for everybody. I don't think that somebody like me needs a therapist.
Yeah.
And I don't know, that might sound a little arrogant, but I really do think, to me, just from my experience, I feel like I'm really good at, like, studying myself, mm-hmm. and, like, asking myself questions of, like, why I am the way I am, or why I respond to certain things. And I record a lot of stuff, so I can look back at a lot of stuff.
Mm.
And I feel like, for me, that has been, like, my own form of, like, personal therapy. So I don't feel like I need to, like, talk to nobody that I don't know. Because anything that's, like, on my heart, I don't, like, I'm pretty transparent with anybody. Like,
yeah, facts.
So I can talk to anybody. You don't got to be a stranger. Like, yeah. I don't care. I don't really worry about being judged. And I feel like, I don't know, talking to people that I love, like my friends, my family, like, I trust their judgment more than a stranger.
Yeah, facts on everything.
So,
especially a stranger who's trying to get paid.
Yeah.
And they can be like, yeah, you might need about 2-3 more sessions for this one. Like,
yeah.
But in all reality, you don't. But go ahead, my fault for interrupting you.
No, but like, ultimately, I feel like for me, a therapist just feels like a middleman to answers that I know I got inside of me myself.
Facts.
Like, I can find them. Like, then, what am I asking? Why would I ask you to tell me who I am?
Facts.
Like, then, so.
And the main therapist who knows everything is God. So, like.
Yes. Yeah, so I might as well. God.
On everything. There's no purpose of going. You're right. So, I might not need an actual therapist because I do just, you know, pray and talk to God about it. Then I'm where I am now. I'm a better man. I'm not as crazy as I used to be. Okay. I still have my moments though. Cause like I said, I ain't perfect, but you know, I ain't gonna lie. Like I said, I like being honest. People, y'all gotta have some sense, cause common sense ain't common no more. Y'all gotta get some damn sense and stop acting stupid. I have no patience for ignorant, stupid ass people. Like, make it make sense, man. That's all I gotta say.
Okay.
That's all I gotta say.
I was gonna say though, since you brought up God, like, I think it's important to say that you don't have to subscribe to religions and stuff to build your connection with God. Cause I feel like I have experienced God very, like, untraditionally. Mm-hmm. Like, I've never been like a church girl or just reading the Bible and stuff. Like, I never really understood a lot in the Bible and stuff like that. I always wanted to, like, I'll pick it up and I'll be like, I don't get it.
So yeah,
I need the baby Bible, like,
yeah, everything.
Toddlers. But even that is just. But I think that everybody is meant to experience God in like a unique way. Yeah, mm-hmm. Like to them, that's gonna resonate with them, and that can be in any way. Like, it don't gotta be through being a Christian or a Buddhist or a Muslim. Facts. Or whatever. Like, because ultimately, most religions are
the same
concept.
Literally,
yeah.
Just different name, goddamn, yeah. Just a little tweak different.
Yeah, but it's all like referring to the same source.
Exactly, God.
So it's like, yeah, I feel like some people will be like, well, how am I going to build a connection with God? But I don't resonate with the Bible or with church or whatever. Like, God is going to find you in whatever way. Facts. Like, God can reach you the best.
Because God is within you.
Yeah.
He created you. In his image, which means God is of you and you are of God. So just talk to him. He right there. He right here. Right here.
Yeah, that's really like the answer to everything.
Facts. You know, I got a question. Hot question. I want to ask you because I was thinking about this the other day. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you was an object. What object would you be? Or like, if you was an object and people, what object you think people would think you are, and what object you think you would be?
What object would people think I am?
Yeah, like, what do you think people think of you, and what, like, type situation? And then like if you was an bump that bump answer the inanimate object question first. So if you was an inanimate object, what an inanimate object would you be?
Does the sun count? I would want to be the sun.
I mean, technically, you got life. Because okay. It's energy.
Okay, well, I don't know. An inanimate object? I would probably want to be like a kaleidoscope. A really cool kaleidoscope.
A kaleidoscope?
Yeah.
Why?
Because I think they're cool.
Okay, that's different. I ain't gonna lie.
You can, like, look into a kaleidoscope and be like, wow, that's cool. Like,
so you want people to look inside you, like, oh yeah, she's really cool and colorful.
Yeah, well, like, everything, I've never thought about being in an inanimate object. Like, everything I can think of is, like, stuff that you would probably say that don't count.
What?
Like, a rainbow. Or, like,
a rainbow?
I don't know.
You can't hold a rainbow, though.
Okay, it has to be something you can hold, then I guess a kaleidoscope. I don't know. Like, I guess it has to be a kaleidoscope.
Yeah, nah. It's just funny.
Or like a prism.
Yeah, a prism. Like, what would you do with the prism?
You can just hold it and you can put it in the sun and it'll make a rainbow.
So we're going to give you a rainbow with an asterisk on the side. You know what I'm saying? Her inanimate object is a rainbow with an asterisk. It may be real. Oh, it's real, but like, cause it.
Yeah, I don't know.
If that it might be like broccoli, cause you know, like, broccoli is not technically a real vegetable, but it's under the vegetable family.
Yeah, but you can hold broccoli.
Yeah, but.
But.
You can see a rainbow. But you can't hold it, you know what I'm saying? You can taste the rainbow.
But so what's your answer?
My answer, I think I would be an umbrella. Or I think people will like look at myself as like an umbrella, you know what I'm saying?
Okay. Like, I feel like you thought deeply of it.
But it's this anime show I had seen, so it kinda like resonated with it a little bit, you know what I'm saying? Cause maybe because like past like year and a half or whatever, but yeah, name like with some people or some like relationships that, you know, that had come and gone, you know what I'm saying? I was helping people and with that person through their sad phase or whatever, or their stormy phase. So like I was that you know, that umbrella to, you know, help them get their spirits back up, and then, you know what I'm saying, when they got their sunshine back, you know what I'm saying, they threw me to the corner.
Ooh. That sounds like a poem.
Alright, then they just wanted me for the rainy days, or needed me for the rainy days. So like,
dang.
Yeah. So like that's why I kind of see myself as an umbrella, you know.
So that's like the other question of what people would see you as, right?
Yeah.
So what would you
be? What do you think people see you as? Or
what do I think people see me as?
Yeah. Or like what do you think people think of you? Like, not in inanimate object wise. Like, what do you think people think of you?
I guess I would probably just be some kind of light. Like, I don't know. Like, yeah. A lamp or something.
Yeah.
Or that selfie light.
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess. Yeah. I hope.
Yeah,
I feel like that's a question you gotta ask other people. I feel like for me to answer it, I don't know if it really counts.
I can see you kind of as like a light, and kind of like how you said earlier, like that person that just lives life to the fullest, you know what I'm saying?
Could you think of like a better object?
For you?
Be more on brand, yeah.
Let's really think about it now. I gotta really think about it.
What do people think? You are people. What do you think?
Well, I'm.
I don't know.
I know you though, so like it's not. You know what I'm saying?
We not talking about facts?
Yeah, true. So, if I was to say you as an inanimate object, what inanimate object would you be?
That's a hard question. It's so many objects that you could be, like,
effects.
Literally, like, a plethora. I'm looking around, like, so many things.
I might put you as a microphone or something like that, you know what I'm saying? Because, like, you well-spoken, you know what I'm saying? You can have fun, you know what I'm saying, when necessary, but at the same time, you know what I'm saying, when it's time to, you know, chill or whatever like that, you just by yourself, you know, then you be making mic drop statements sometimes, you know what I'm saying, or moments, you know what I'm saying, like, yo.
Okay.
So, like, I might think about something else, but, you know, there's just something slight, you know what I'm saying.
I like that, I'll take it. Oh, I was gonna ask you, though, how do you experience God? Like, how do you know it's God talking to you?
So you know it's God when God name, you feel it in your spirit. Like, your subconscious or that person that's talking in your head, it's two people that's talking in your head. Really, really three. You got your good side, your bad side, and then you got God. So God name. But when you feel it from God, you'll feel it like literally in your soul, like your spirit, like you're feeling your heart, mind, and soul. So like, cause you know, as humans, of course, you know, sometimes we do stuff that we know we shouldn't do. So like, God would tell us, like, hey, don't go do that, cause you know that ain't the right thing to do, or you know, whatever. But us thinking with our heads, or you know, because we think we God, or you know, we will do whatever we want to do. Something happened wrong, hey, who fault that is? God told you don't go, so it's up to you to listen. Because if you felt it in your spirit, like for example, it was one time, somebody had invited me somewhere. Then, like, I was ecstatic to go, I ain't gonna lie. But then,
ecstatic?
Oh, everything. Yep. copacetic, ecstatic, all these words.
I know ecstatic. I know that word.
What do you mean? But goddamn, so like literally the day of, probably like 4 hours before, like I was like, I'm not really feeling the, like some, you know, some ain't feeling too good, you know what I'm saying? So like I end up, you know, not going. And then like the place that I was supposed to go, somebody got to fighting, stuff done happen, you know what I'm saying? Shots was fired. I don't think nobody got shot, but like still the fact that, you know, that happened, you know, like I don't want to be in those type of situations, you know what I'm saying? I was in those situations before. Luckily, my bro, he the one who told me to duck. So goddamn. But yeah.
That's interesting. I kind of have a similar story, but I do agree. Last year, I feel like is when I really, really learned that I have to follow my intuition. Mm-hmm. Like, I used to ignore my intuition all the time. I'll still be doing it sometimes, but I'm really trying to stand on business.
Facts, I heard that. Like,
because honestly, I don't know, whenever you don't listen to your intuition, you're gonna regret it.
Thanks.
Because it's really like just for, it's in your best interest every time. Like,
thanks.
But I think sometimes it just be like, it feels subtle. Like, it's like God will just say something like, I don't know, go pick up that shoe. Mm-hmm. And it's just like, well, why? Why do I need to do that? I'm not doing that. That's stupid. Like,
that's crazy.
But it's like, I don't know.
Yeah.
That's how I be, but it's like,
it has
maybe
a purpose.
Next week I realize, like, dang, I should have just picked up that shoe when it came to me. Like,
yeah.
Hey, if you're feeling like that,
you ain't the only one, because that's literally how it be.
Yeah.
Like, those, like, my fault for interrupting you, but like those quick like thoughts in my head, like how you just said, like, hey, go do this right quick. I'm like, what? That wasn't even like even crossing my mind. So why the hell it just like came out of my mind out of nowhere? That's how I know it's God. You know what I'm saying? Because like, all right, do this, like, do it, you know what I'm saying? Because if you don't, like you said, next week or a couple days or even a couple hours later, I'm going to be like, damn, I should have did that.
Yeah. And sometimes it don't even be for you. I was watching this TikTok, and this girl said she went to the grocery store to get some flowers. And they didn't have the flowers she wanted or something, so she just got, like, this random bouquet. And when she was walking out the store, she just felt something say, give the flowers to that lady.
Yeah.
She was like, no, these my flowers.
Like, talking about everything.
Flowers. Like, what you mean? And then she felt it again, like, give flowers to that lady. So she was just like, okay, like, fine. Mm-hmm. I'm going to give her the flowers. So she gave the lady the flowers. And she was like, the lady was like, oh my gosh, this is so crazy. Like, every year since I met my husband, he gave me, like, 3 yellow daisies. And I walked in that store and I tried to find a bouquet with 3 yellow daisies, but I didn't see any. So that's so crazy, because the bouquet that the girl gave her had 3 yellow daisies in it, and her husband had just died last week. And she was like, he used to give me 3 yellow daisies every Thursday, and he died last week. And the day that she gave her the flowers was on Thursday. And she just started crying.
That's God,
and I was,
man.
Like, that is,
that's
crazy.
That's God, man.
That is nothing but God.
Like, he works in mysterious ways.
Yeah.
Man. Like, you just gotta follow your intuition, like, no second guessing. That's why I've been, you know, more heavy on this year as well, because like the last part of last year, like the ending or whatever, like that junk is like me being on my own, you know, reacting on my own and not listen to my intuition, you know what I'm saying? Like, nah, I feel like doing this, so I'm gonna do this. You know what I'm saying? That's the position that I'm in right now. You know what I'm saying? But I'm gonna be listening to my intuition from now on, you know?
You got to, yeah.
And you know, that will waste my time and my energy. It almost cost me my peace as well. And I ain't finna goddamn let that happen. Not no more.
Let's give it up for Jam! But yeah, that's kind of like what I was saying earlier. Like, when you do what you're called to do, it's not just for you. Like, it's for everybody. Mm-hmm. Like, it's affecting other people too. It's like the butterfly effect.
It is the butterfly effect. Most
and that's why I'm trying to take the butterfly effect more seriously. Because I'm like, I've been feeling like I need to make a YouTube for so long, but I'm like, I don't really want to.
Yeah.
I don't want to have to edit. I don't want to have to, like, I don't know, care about.
Yeah, I hate
it. So much, but I feel like I'm supposed
you gotta
to.
You got to do it. Thanks. Sure. I guarantee you, this episode right here, hopefully people watch it. If you don't, I could care less. You know what I'm saying? Honestly speaking, I want you to watch it. Don't get me wrong, but.
Nah, this is the one that's going to blow up. This is the Cat Williams episode.
Yeah, everything. This is the one you need to watch. Very informational. You know what I'm saying? You got a wise woman right here. You know what I'm saying? And also.
Greats in the land, wise is in the land.
I don't know about that part.
I don't know about that one.
But she's also our first woman guest, so applause on that.
Okay. Woo. Let's give it up for the ladies.
Who run the world? Me. No, I'm just playing. But what I was gonna say. Yeah, like hold on, what were we talking about?
We was talking about following your intuition.
Yeah, the butterfly effect and all that stuff. Yeah, so like that's why I had to start, you know, the podcast, you know what I'm saying? Also being more serious about my art because, you know, like, God gave me talents and gave us ideas and placed these stuff in our heads to create, for, like you said, for not only ourselves, but mainly for other people, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. So, like, I got to stop being selfish with my craft and with my talents that God gave me and actually utilize them for my purpose, and which is why I'm doing it now.
That's good. I love that. Mm-hmm. I feel like me going to Mexico is like the me really
the big
standing on faith for real. Like me really following my heart and my intuition and God and all of that. Because I ain't got no type of plan. Everybody's like, well, how you gonna make money out there? Where are you gonna stay? Where are you gonna do this? And I'm like, I don't know. I just know I need to go, so I'm gonna just go and just see what happens.
Yeah,
like, I don't know how long I'm gonna be there or none of that, but I'm not worried.
Facts. I was like, I'll go carry you, man.
Yeah.
Like, I ain't gonna lie.
Like, I seen this quote that said, jump and the net will appear. Like, you're not gonna see your safety net until after you jump. So,
it
like,
is true.
The steps will start lighting up as you start stepping. So, that's what I'm gonna have faith in. Faith over fear, for real.
Facts. Like, you can't. You gotta see, you gotta walk and see with your third eye instead of your normal two eyes, you know what I'm saying?
For sure.
Because you ain't gonna get a lot of stuff done if you're just looking with your two eyes, you know what I'm saying? It's this one picture I seen. It was like, you know, them little clip arts, like with the elections and stuff like that, what they be making or whatever. It was like, it wasn't like dealing with the elections, but it was like a picture. So, like, a dude, so it was like a window, right, of like a clear view, right? So like at the far left you had a dude who couldn't even see like the view or whatever because, you know, he didn't have enough under him to, you know, see the view. And then it was a person who was in the right view, like they seen the view or whatever because they had enough like knowledge or whatever under them. But the third person, they couldn't see the view because they was over it because they thought they knew everything and that they couldn't really see the picture.
Mm-hmm.
So you gotta have balance, you know what I'm saying?
For sure.
And I learned that this year as well. You gotta have a balance.
And if you don't, life will humble you.
Life will humble you so, very quickly.
Yeah.
Very quickly. It's just funny, man. But I'm not arrogant. I'm not, you know.
Yeah. I really think the best way to balance that, well, for me, that I found is gratitude. Like, really celebrating the small wins and just appreciating everything that's, I guess you would say, is small, but nothing's really small for real. Like, everything matters. It's like the butterfly effect for
facts.
Real. So I feel like as long as you're appreciative of everything that you have, that's when God like rewards you with more.
Mm-hmm.
So I feel like that's the best way to find balance.
Facts. You gotta have that gratitude.
Yeah.
And be accepting. For like, I ain't gonna say accept it for everything, cause you know some things you can't accept.
Yeah.
But like, I don't know. Nah, I gotta think about that statement more before I say it. Everything. That was gonna sound straight up stupid. What I was gonna say.
It's not like you're trying to say like, you don't have to accept everything, but like, you don't have to. I don't know, put so much energy into being angry about it.
Facts. Oh, everything.
You can just move on with your life.
Exactly.
Pushing.
or anything.
Like, you can show love from a distance.
Exactly.
You can love lots of
things. Mm-hmm. But did you die? No, you didn't. So keep it moving.
That's a big lesson. But I wonder if, like, everybody has to learn that lesson, or if it comes easily to people to just, like, learn to look from a distance or, like, detach.
No, you know, people...
That was hard for me.
Detachment is very, very, very difficult. Especially, like, if you love something, like, if you love that thing or that person, like, detachment is very hard. Like,
yeah.
Like, it took me a good little minute to detach myself from Honey Buns. Like, and John, yeah, dang. I ain't had no Honey Bun in about 2 weeks
now.
What
did you have to do? Like, what do you feel like your strategy
to
keep it going, keep it consistent?
Whenever I go to the store, and I got to speed past the snack aisle.
You can't even look at them.
I can't even look at them because if I see one, it look good.
No, that is a good little formula though. Out of sight, out of mind.
Yeah, facts. That's out of sight, out of mind.
Whoever made that up, they was talking about that.
Facts.
That's definitely true.
No, anything. That's how I be moving. That's how I be operating. Cause you know, like, that's what it, like, things and people. Cause like, I can't make myself accessible to people who leeching off of me, or if I feel like I'm not getting the same thing reciprocated, or you know, if it's not being like appreciated, you know, in the way that it should be, because you know, I don't have to, you know, help you out or you know, be in your life or whatever, and vice versa, you know what I'm saying? I'd be grateful, you know, happy if you know, whenever I hang out with somebody or whenever somebody give me something, but like, it. People don't appreciate that much no more. Like,
that's very true. But then you also preach unconditional love and stuff. So it's like, which one is it?
I'm not Jesus. I'm not God. So like, you know what I'm saying? I'm trying to find that.
But God is in you.
He is.
So tap in.
I'm trying. You know what I'm saying?
No, I get what you're saying. And you do have to distance yourself from situations or whatever. But it's also, I do think it's not enough people saying that showing grace is okay. Some people do deserve second chances and they will learn. But you gotta decipher and use your discernment of who's worth it for you and who's Thanks. Not worth the energy. But there's a lot of people who are worth the energy. That's all I'm saying. Well, that I've experienced. I don't know who everybody else got around.
I was gonna say,
I don't know.
I ain't gonna say everybody, it's some people, because it's a good majority. It's probably 50-50 in our, like, honesty, but, like, it just seemed like it's only a few amount that's actually, like, real and, like, how you say it?
Yeah.
Like, good energy people or whatever. Because, like, I'm gonna be honest, like I said, I'm gonna be honest, you know what I'm saying? I don't like telling lies or whatever. So, like, the umbrella situation came from goddamn me making myself too accessible to like girls who didn't appreciate me, you know what I'm saying? Like I'm trying to, you know, show you that you know, that you're not, I'm not treating you like how I treat every other, you know, woman or whatever. But like, I know as a man, you know what I'm saying, I feel happy helping, you know, people move into their house or decorate or whatever. I love HGTV. You know, it's very, very hot. But yeah, okay. You know what I'm saying? So like, I help them move their stuff into their crib or whatever. And then like, just the, you know, the next week, you know what I'm saying, I don't get no text, no call, like, no hey, bye, go to hell, nothing. So like, what's up with the wishy-washiness, you know what I'm saying? So, like...
Did you ask?
Yeah. But, you know, I had to accept it, because, like I said, to be honest, you know what I'm saying? The feelings wasn't reciprocated, you know what I'm saying? They wasn't, you know, mutual, so I had to accept that, and, you know, just had to make my decision on my own. But I let it happen twice, which was my fault on my part, because, you know, at first I used to live, you know, one strike you out, but then I realized you ain't gonna have no no friends or, you know, especially not no relationship, you know what I'm saying? If you just cut everybody off for the first time, you know what I'm saying? They do something you don't like, hey, why you eating that pizza like that? You know what I'm saying? Like,
you know what I'm saying?
Everything. So then I switched it to baseball rules, so it's just 3 strikes, you're out. But I was like, that's too many chances. Cause like, you know what I'm saying? Like, me personally, especially as an adult, you know, that was like younger days, you know, when I was like 20, 21 and stuff, whatever. But like, especially now, like, in my opinion, if you over 20, really, well, nah, because some of these teenagers stupid as hell, but god dang, if you over 20, you really gotta learn like how to be a young adult and communicate like an adult should, you know, how to communicate. Because like if I'm telling you how I feel, honestly, I expect that to be reciprocated. Like, don't beat around the bush or give me a little bit of the truth. Like, tell me straight up how it is. So like, the first two times, you know, the person didn't really tell me exactly how they was feeling or whatever. They were being around the bush until I had to legit up ask, you know, the exact verbatim question, you know what I'm saying? Like, yes or no, then that jumped me crazy. So, like, adults, y'all gotta goddamn get y'all communicative skills down pat, because communication goes a long way, not just in relationships, but in anything, like business, friendships, sports, you name it. Even ordering a hot dog from the hot dog stand, you know what I'm saying? Sir, can I get some extra ketchup on that? You know what I'm saying? Something like that, you know?
Yeah, I get you. I agree. I also feel like, I don't know, it is just important for people to remember that everything don't, like, every problem isn't because of you. Like, I don't know. So I feel like in those instances, it's okay to show grace, because it's like, you never know what people going through for real, and how, like, outside stuff can affect, like, how they interact with people because they're just frustrated about something else that don't got nothing to do with you. And at the end of the day, like, nobody's perfect. People make mistakes. So I don't know. If I feel like it's some people who, like, will have a friend, if they make a mistake or say something, then it's like, you're blocked and I'm never talking to you again. You're dead to me. Right. And I feel like you don't even give people the opportunity to learn from their mistake and come back and apologize. And a lot of people actually will apologize. Mm-hmm. But yeah, you got to give them that chance too. If you shut everybody out, then you're not going to really get the opportunity to grow with people and have long-term relationships. Because at the end of the day, no relationship, whether it's romantic or platonic, is perfect.
Nothing's perfect.
And we'll never have like bumps in the road, or you're never going to agree with somebody 100% with somebody else, because y'all are two different people coming from two different walks of life.
Facts.
So it's just like, I don't know. I think people can be a little bit more just
open-minded,
I guess. And just practice forgiveness better. I feel like our generation is losing the art of forgiveness, and it's really important. Like, not just for them, but for you too.
Facts, everything.
Yeah.
Especially that part of life for you, because, like, you could be hurt in trying to, goddamn, wait for that person to apologize or whatever. You're going to be waiting forever and a day and still hurt, because that person probably in bed sleep peacefully.
Yeah.
And you're over there stressing. Like, you don't want to be, like, one of those type of people. That's going to be funny. I mean, it's not funny, but it's funny. But you know
what I mean? Like, I cannot hold a grudge. Are you a grudge holder?
It depends. Like, for the most part, no. Because, like, I like to kind of live my life like water. You know what I'm saying? Like, it flows. You know what I'm saying? Whatever happens, happens. You know what I'm saying? Whatever we do. At the same time, I'm still human. That's like part of the reason why I say I kind of need a therapist. Like, when my ex had cheated on me, like, that's a grudge I had to hold. You know what I'm saying? Because, like, why the fuck you cheat on me? You know what I'm saying? Like, no arrogant stuff, but like, it's me. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, did the dude who she cheated on me with? Like, I'm like, it is what it is.
I have to say though, I feel like I hate the disclaimer of having to say, like, I'm not arrogant. I'm not, like, I say this humbly or blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
Like, it's okay to speak highly of yourself.
Facts, like, most definitely.
you don't have to give a disclaimer. I'm not arrogant. Who cares if somebody thinks it's arrogant? Like, you know who you are.
That is true. I think.
That's how I feel.
Yeah, I am the best, what she said. Well, she didn't say I'm the best, but I'm the best.
You are the best.
Thank
and
you.
I'm the greatest. Okay. I think that was a great episode, I gotta say. I feel like I dropped some gems.
She did.
I had to send this one.
Woo, she did.
I don't even remember what I said, but I feel like it was some good stuff.
You know, that wraps up this episode of the Brothers Podcast. It's your boy, Cameron McLovin. Black Chip Skylark, Shani the Great, the greatest in line. See you next time.
Thanks for having me.
No, it's a play. Thank y'all. Let's y'all have a good week. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, there's that C A M P F R N T S O N T song. But no, for real, for real. Y'all have a blessed one. You know what I'm saying? Peace and love, everybody. Y'all spread it. You know, help somebody out. You know what I'm saying? Love yourself. Love others. Love God. All that good stuff.
Follow your heart.
Follow your heart.
And be the change you want to see.
Be the change you want to see. Be an example. Lead by example. Follow this page, though.
Follow me at Greatest in the Land on TikTok and Instagram.
You said you had Instagram.
I deleted the app, but I mean the account is still there. I might go viral one day. I might have.
Fans, like they follow her on Instagram and TikTok. She said it. It's gonna be somewhere on the screen, somewhere. But yeah, thank y'all for tapping in, and see y'all later.
Bye.
Bye. Have a beautiful time.
Bye. Have a beautiful time. 3
Take
2.
All right, dude, take 2. So, just in case the audio and the, you know, the video got sliced, you know what I'm saying, because camera settings and all that stuff, we are doing the outros one more again. This episode, you know, here's your boy Cameron McLovin, the Black Chip Skylark, Shani the Great, greatest in the land, signing off. But anyway, yeah, you know, be a leader, you know, love God, love yourself, you know, love others, you know. She said follow your heart, you know.
Be the change you
want to
see.
Be the change you want to see. Follow her
and
on.
And just vibe.
Yeah, vibe, you know, go with the flow. Trust your intuition, go with your gut. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, Instagram, TikTok.
Yeah, follow me at Greatest in the Land on TikTok and on Instagram.
Right, right. You know what I'm saying? Signing off.
If you want to. Bye, have a beautiful time.
Bye, have a beautiful time.
This is funny.